Hello, and welcome to Judging by the Cover,
where we'll be judging Detective Comics number 27, by the cover. Detective Comics 27 is a vintage comic book that apparently may have come out in 1939, most famous in the annals of comic history for featuring the first appearance of DC's most popular character, Tommy Tartan the Detective Lumberjack, and his plucky sidekick Philip. Tommy Tartan, the Detective Lumberjack, is of course famous for his uncanny ability to solve crimes involving very tall things that one might conceivably need to chop down. We see here that he has embarked upon his most famous mystery, the case of the really weirdly tall chimney pipe. Why was the chimney pipe 6 feet tall? Surely once the pipe extends outside the building, then anything more than 1 or 2 feet is just a waste of perfectly good aluminium. Tommy Tartan takes the case, and quickly discovers a sinister conspiracy of vice involving a local pimp and his illicit rooftop pole dancing lessons, aided by his co-conspirator boyfriend, who moonlights as a gothic shower curtain salesman, and whose legs were blown off in the war, replaced by makeshift prosthetics fashioned from the nose cones of air-to-air missiles. "Just when I thought I'd seen it all," mutters Tommy Tartan, as Philip brandishes the iconic screwdriver from which he takes his name. Oh yes, and apparently this issue also features the amazing and unique adventures of the Batman, who is probably some kind of crime-solving cricket player. Unique's always an odd word to put in a blurb, isn't it? Because it's textbook damning with fine praise. A bloke who destroys Fabergé eggs with sledgehammers could certainly be said to have a unique approach to antique restoration, but I doubt his workshop would stay in the black. So if I'm reading these movement lines correctly, then Joe Pinstripe over here was standing on that rooftop with the mysterious chimney and was swept upwards. So if the perspective isn't completely fucked, and let's face it, it may well be, then we're dealing with either a very small rooftop or a very large man. Not so large, you'll note that he isn't above cacking himself, because I can't think of a more appropriate interpretation for the black turd-shaped object falling away from the poor bastard's hindquarters. Oh no, my shoehorn has fallen out of my back pocket. Just doesn't scan, does it? Yes, it's a little unusual that the turd somehow phased through his trousers and underpants instead of dropping meekly out of a trouser leg, but then it's also pretty unusual to give pole dancing lessons on a rooftop. This is the world we live in. Presumably, he's cacking himself in fear because he's being attacked by a miniature alien spacecraft, cunningly disguised as a hat, but which has now revealed its deception as it fires a stream of tracer rounds towards his outstretched hand. The danger signal took its time reaching his brain, though, as it looks like his face is between two expressions. Cover up his mouth, and his furrowed brow reflects anger and concern, but his mouth is bent into a little smile of thoughtful placitude as his friend strokes his hair with his surgical gloves and delicately massages his windpipe. He reminds me of a dog who reacted fearfully at the initial touch, but begins to calm down when he realizes he's getting a belly scratch. This was assuming the black thing immediately under the nose was his mouth. It could be the same situation as that dude on the Superman comic where that's actually his moustache, and the little hole underneath is the mouth, pursed into a little gape of delighted surprise. Neither explanation really fits what's supposed to be going on in this scene, so maybe both these weird black shapes are moustaches, and the dude's mouth is actually that huge triangular expanse of black underneath, and he's some kind of bizarre alien with a flip-top head like a Pez dispenser. That might go some of the way towards explaining what the shower curtain salesman's line could possibly be attached to, assuming that the enormous red band where the title goes isn't actually physically there, like it's Clifford the Big Red Dog's Todger poised to start humping a neighbouring radio mast or something. None of the surrounding buildings are remotely tall enough to grapple from. And there's only one layer of background buildings before featureless yellow sky, so I guess we're on the rooftops of a small truck stop in the desert. The only remaining explanation is that he's a member of the Galactic Police rappelling down from his hovering spaceship to arrest Fliphead McFizzbook's wanted space criminal. Sadly, if you want to know how this titanic tussle between the forces of order and chaos will end, then you're going to have to pay 10 whole nipples to buy the book. Let's just say it'll probably be something terribly unique.